You know, I've been thinking a lot about NateLejeune.com, and it's crazy that over a year ago, we started putting together the site, and man, how much life has changed for all of us in a year's time. I mean, before we started it, there was like these rumors of this virus named COVID out there, the coronavirus, but it wasn't really a real thing in our lives. And the site was originally just put together to help share insights and ideas that would inspire people. This idea of making our Christianity tangible. I also kind of wanted to connect what I do in my profession right now of training coaches and using the power of sports-based youth development techniques and strategies to help encourage people to create safe spaces for kids. But also those techniques, whether people knew them or not, were deeply rooted and grounded in biblical concepts. And I just believe that, yes, they applied to sports and they applied to youth programming, but they also just applied to leadership and leadership skills. And I felt like they were really great techniques and strategies that churches could use to help their leadership, to help their youth programs, and to help all the aspects of what people were connecting with other people who needed a healing place, and how they were able to connect and create that place where people could heal and connect with God on a deeper level. And so NateLejeune.com was put together to share our story, to see where people were, where their stories and where those two things could connect. And I was gonna write blogs and I was gonna share all of these thoughts from Instagram, and then life changed in March of 2019. And honestly, between pulling 50, 60 hours a week at work to becoming the lead pastors and starting this brand new thing called Home Church, everything changed. Our Instagram changed, our YouTube changed. I no longer had the time or energy to write blogs anymore. And all of my time had to go into Home Church and into work, and also the Grown Folks Online community, which if you're a gamer, I run a gaming community. And God's been allowing me to use these different aspects of myself to create these really healing-centered places for people, a place where people could come, be themselves, really engage with other people, and experience some type of, for some of us, just a place to unplug, and for others, a place to really heal and be able to find the things that we need to grow ourselves as people. And so I've been thinking lately, about 5 years ago, 6 years ago, I got into streaming. It's my way to unplug. It's my way to just kind of be who I am and do my thing. And I'm always working at my craft. I've been speaking now for over 10 years, which is really crazy to think about. And I'm constantly working at my craft. I tell people all the time, like, I'm the most average dude. Like, I am the most average Joe that you'll ever meet. And you see these really talented people that engage with you with stories, and they're super energetic and they just pull you in. And I'm not that guy. I've had to really work at it. I'm actually like very shy and an introvert, and I've had to work at getting comfortable in front of a camera for the past year. And for the 9 years before that, getting comfortable about how do you engage with crowds and how do you move people through a thought or a concept? How do you connect them with information? And I've been really engaging with streaming for the past 6 years because I love this aspect that you can create this experience that people enjoy and are entertained by. And when you create this online experience, that people are actually influenced by you and they want to learn what you have. And it's a great way just to share the tips and the tricks that you've learned. And so there's been a couple of guys that I've learned over the years. Harris Keller from Alpha Gaming, Sam Woodhall, who is also connected with Alpha Gaming, and even lately, a guy named Big E. None of these guys will ever see this. They've probably never even heard of my name. And I've been watching how they do things, and I love people who freely give out of their gifts and talents, and something I try to do, and try to just freely give what's been freely given to me. And this guy named Big E on YouTube has a website where it's all about video content. And I'm always in front of a camera, I'm always creating content. And so I was like, this is the way to go. So here is the big change to NateLejeune.com is we're going full video content. Of course, we're still gonna link the Instagram page and the small concepts and tips and tricks that we do. But most of our content is no longer gonna be written blogs, but they're just gonna be video content where I just share leadership thoughts or small ideas or things that maybe I'm working my way through. We're just going to turn on the camera, be who we are, and share where we are in hopes that maybe our story influences yours. Maybe what we're going through helps you where you're at and you can pull something away from it to apply to your life. So NateLejeune.com is going under a small overhaul. I hope that you keep coming back. You're going to see some stuff from Home Church on here. I'm going to try to be more intentional about plugging in with some of the training concepts I have and sharing small thoughts and clips from some of the training that I've been exposed to over the years in hopes that it blesses you and that you're able to find what you need to influence and affect your story through that. NateLejeune.com. Keep hanging out with us. HomeChurch217.com is our church. And hey, if you're a gamer, come check us out. GrownFolksOC.com. Come play some video games with us. All right. We'll see you later. I love you. Peace.